to continue with the series of tutorial demonstration about using the Wouxun KG-UV920P's remote control functions, I will be discussing for part 7 of the series, remotely changing the RX-CTC tone of the KG-UV920P. So for this demonstration, we will be using our dual bender here and a Baofeng UV-5R as our HT controller, as you can see there. Let's set that aside. And another Baofeng UV-5R, I have labeled the radio 2 to demonstrate the RX-CTC functions later on in the video. Set that aside first also. Now, going back to the flowchart guide that I have printed out or made, this 7th of the video is procedure 3E. So change RX-CTC tone under main function 3, because as we all know, there are 3 functions which you can control remotely. So there is remote stun, and then remote power off, power on, and then remote changing of transceiver settings. And then under this topic, there are 6 settings that you can change remotely. I have discussed already A, B, C, D, and for this part 7, I will focus on changing the RX-CTC tone, or the so-called reception continuous tone coded squelch tone, CTCS. Okay. Now let's power up the dual bander.
Frequency mode.
Right now we are in frequency mode. So for purposes of demonstration, we will be using the following operating frequencies. For side A, we have 462.550, and for side B, we have 155.180. Also, I have set the power level of both sides to low power, so that's about 5 watts only, 5 watts of TX power. Aside from the power setting, we will also have set the RX-CTC tone, the default RX-CTC tone of our side A frequency to a random number, a random code. So to access RX-CTC, we key in. So since we are in side A, so we key in menu.
Function select.
That's 2-6. So there's RX-CTC. So right now it is set to off. So we choose a random tone here. Let's say 88.5, and then confirm with a menu. Now, for radio 2, we will use the same operating frequency of 462.550. And on the Baofeng, you can see here that it's dialed in to 462.550. And the TX CTCS tone for this should be set to the tone that our side A is currently on. So since side A is using a tone or a CTS tone of 88.5, we should also set this to a TX CTS tone of 88.5 in order for this to communicate with the KG-UV920P, or in order for the traffic or the transmission of the radio 2 to open up the speaker of the Wouxun KG-UV920P. So let's set it this way. It's, I think it's menu 1.3. So right now it is set to off.
So CTCSS.
So what happens when it is on off, set to off, is that even if I transmit, see? Okay. So the transmission is being picked up, but it is not opening the speaker. So even if I say something, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, nothing comes out of the speaker. But if we set the transceivers, the HD's TCTS tone to 88.5, which is the same tone used by side A.
CTCSS.
So we set this to 88.5, confirm it with the menu, and then this time, you see, okay, it opens up the speaker mic.
Check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3.
Roger tone of this HD is also set to off. You turn it on and it should have a radio tone at the end of the transmission. Let's check it.
Check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3. Check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3.
So that's for side A. And now we proceed to side B. We hold the SP mic and then press button 1 to shift to side B. And for side B, we have an operating frequency of 155.180. This time, the RX-CTCS will be set to off. Okay.
Enter.
Okay. You will notice that when the CTS tone is set, there's that CT icon on top. So right now we have not set the CTCS tone of this, so there is no CT icon there. So once we have set up both sides, we should see to it that the master frequency display icon, that inverted pyramid, black pyramid there, should be located on side B. So because we will be controlling our KG-UV920P using that frequency, so this would serve as our HD controller here. A Baofeng UV-5R, I have labeled the radio 1 here, and as you can see, it's 1, 3. The CTCS is off.
CTCSS.
So,
confirm.
If I transmit, it should be picked up, or it should open up the speaker of the KG-UV920P transceiver. So let's try it.
Check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3.
So it has the tone, so let's try to turn it off. So that's menu 39. Roger tone is on, set it to off, and then
check 1, 2, 3, 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 check 1, 2, 3.
Right. So we now have both of the demo HDs configured and the KG-UV920P configured also. Then we could proceed to do procedure A. So procedure A is required in order for us to do all of these things shown here. So before you can do that and procedure B, you must first perform procedure A. So this is just one time activation of the remote control feature. So after we have activated this, we could leave the SP mic behind or set it aside, so because for the rest of these procedures, we will be using now our HD controller. Okay, so to do procedure A, we hold the SP mic, and then you key in menu 44, menu on and menu. So let's do it right now. So that's menu, menu 44. So RCSW. Okay, press menu to enter selection, and then from the options, there are only two actually options. So it's either off or on. Using the up button, you choose on, and then to confirm, press menu again. And then the KG-UV920P will reboot, this time with the remote control feature activated. You will also notice that on the faceplate, on the panel or LCD, there is this icon indicating that both sides are now locked and RCSW is now, or our remote control feature is now activated. So both sides are now locked, so we can no longer use the buttons here, except of course for the lock button, which would unlock it. Okay. Now that we have done procedure A, we can now proceed to doing procedure 3E as our main objective. So to change the RX-CTS tone, it says here that hold the PTT of the HD controller, use the code 05 plus the 4-digit CTCSS tone. After that, you release the PTT. Remember, for codes less than 3-digit, you must begin it with a 0. For example, a CTCSS code of 67.0 kHz should be entered on the HD controller as 0670 and not 67.0 only. Okay, so less than 3 digits, you should begin it with a 0. So 050670. So let's try it right now. So, by the way, I forgot. It is important also to note once again that for every setting that you want to change remotely, you must first do procedure B. Okay, so every time you want to change the RX-CTS tone, you do procedure B first and then proceed to the ones written in red here. So what is procedure B? Procedure B is holding the HD controller, and then you hold the PTT of the HD controller, you key in 123 pound menu down, the release, and then release the PTT. After you have done so, there would be a confirmation beep or a beep, and then within 30 seconds, you do now this using the code here, stated here. So let's try it. So since our master frequency display icon is on side B, then we should be using the same frequency on the HD controller. So procedure B first. Procedure B is all the PTT, and then 1, 2, 3, menu down. There is that confirmation, and then you do 05 to change RX-CTCS tone, and then the new tone, which is 0670. So you can see now that on side B there is that CT icon already, indicating that we have successfully changed it to the tone that we have keyed in here. So how do we check? So right now, as you can see, the CTS tone of our transmitter is HT controller, I mean, is set to off. Okay. So if we try to transmit, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3. Check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3. So it does not open up the speaker of the KG-UV920P. Check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3. Now, the way this CTCS tone works is that it will filter out any unwanted traffic or transmission to open up the speaker of your transceiver. So every time that an unwanted transmission goes in to the same frequency that you are using, if it does not have the corresponding or the matching CTCSS tone, it will not open up the speaker. Thus, no audio would be heard. So it does not mean to say that the transmission is not coming through. Does not mean to say that your communication now is secured. So it does not offer any security at all if you would look at it that way, because it will only filter out unwanted transmission. The transmission is still going through. Okay, as you can see here, if I press this, our KG-UV920P is still receiving it, but not opening up the speaker. So even if I say something from this HD controller, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, nothing is heard on the SP mic. Now, this a remote changing of the CTCS RX-CTC tone of the KG-UV920P would prove useful in cross-band repeat operations. Okay, so for cross-band repeat operations, which we have learned in procedure 3C. Okay, 3C is changing to repeater mode. So you can change the change to the RX-CTS tone, your desired RX-CTS tone, so that when there is an unwanted transmission going on, then you could just change it as desired, so it will not interfere with your communication. Okay, and also you have to, I would have to emphasize that after changing the RX-CTCS tone, both tones, both sides, would share the new CTCSS tone that you have keyed in. So since we have keyed in 67.0 a while ago, then this will also have 67.0 kilohertz as the CTCSS tone. So how do we check for that? So right now we check with radio 2. Right, menu. You can see here it's 13.
CTCSS.
It's 88.5. Okay, so even if I talk, check 1 2 3, check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3, check 1 2 3. It does not open up the speaker of the transceiver because it is using different tone. The transceiver, the transmitter, is not matching up the RX-CTCS tone of the receiver. So the receiver's speaker does not open up, but the transmission went through, as you can see here on the busy signal meter. We will now apply this remote changing of the RX-CTCS tone together with the crossband repeater function of the KG-UV920P. Now, we are currently on normal communication mode, as you can see there on the middle and top middle portion. There is no repeater mode icon, so we will change, we will try this with a crossband repeater. So the code for a crossband repeater is, as you can see in 3C, 03 plus the matching mode code. So for two-way crossband repeat, that would be 03 and 3. So let's try it. Procedure B, 1 2 3, and there's that beep. and then you do 0, 3, and then 3. Now, it reboots to two-way crossband repeater mode. But this time, remember that for every reboot, the default CTCSS tone would be retained. So you will notice that there is no longer that CTCSS tone there, CT icon, I mean, on side B, because we have a power cycled, I mean, the unit itself rebooted. So we do this once again. So right now, so since this would be the default CTCS tone, it should open up the speaker as I transmit. You can see. Okay. So what if we change from the default? So side A now is using the default of 88.5 as we have previously set. So you can see that when I transmit from radio 2 here, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3. So it is being received on the other side of the communication.
Check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3.
Now, same thing happens with if we transmit here.
Check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3.
Okay? Because the CTCS tone of side B is 0 or is currently not active.
Menu.
Same as this, it's the TCTS because we are transmitting, so it's off. Now, what if we turn this both to a CTCSS tone of, let's say, 67.0? So we do this. Procedure B first. So 1, 2, 3, down, menu, down. There's that beep confirmation. And then 0, 5 to change the RX-CTCSS tone of the Wouxun KG-UV920P, and then the 4-digit CTCSS tone is 0, 6, 7, and then 0. Again, there's that beep, and notice that it is now using the newly keyed in CTCSS tone. How do we check for that? Let's see. Transmit from here. Check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3. So it is not opening up the speaker of the transceiver. Thus, it does not transmit to the other side of the communication, to the UHF side. Why? Because
menu.
The CTCSS of the controller is 0, off. So we set this to 1.
CTCSS.
67.0.
Confirm
it, and then exit and try it right now. It's working. So if I say something here,
check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3. So it is
being picked up and received by the UHF radio. But let's check if the UHF radio can transmit to the VHF radio on the other side of the communication. So take note, both of these share the same CTCSS code of an RX-CTCSS code of 67.0 kilohertz. But our transmitter here on the other side of the communication is using what?
Menu.
And a TCTCS of 88.5. What will happen if we use the wrong CTCSS code? So So you can see it does not open up anything. It does not open up the speaker, so no transmission is relayed to the other side of the communication. Thus, our VHF radio there, radio 1, is not receiving anything. Okay, check 1, 2, 3, check 1, 2, 3. Now, we set this to
menu.
The matching CTCSS code of side A, which is what?
CTCSS
67.0. You confirm it.
Confirm.
Then the exit. And let's try it now. So it's working.
Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. This is transmitting from UHF to VHF under CTCSS tone R 67.0.
So you will try to remove the Roger tone here. That's 39. So let's check it out. No more Roger tone. Okay.
Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3.
Now, again, that's how changing the RX-CTCSS tone on the KG-UV920P is done. Now, what if we would like to change from 67.0 kilohertz of RX-CTCSS tone to, let's say, another CTCSS tone value? So let's do it on the HD controller once again. Hold the PTT, and then what are the options for CTCSS tone? Say 88.5. Okay, so PTT, and then 1 2 3 pound key, menu down, release it. There's that confirmation, and then 05, and then 0885. So now it should be on 88.5. So since this is on 67.0, it should not open up the speaker. Let's try it. And there you go. Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. How about on the other side, the VHF, the UHF side of the communication? Same thing happens, because this one is now using 88.5, both sides, huh? They are using 88.5, and then, but our radios here, so for radio 2, it is still using 67.0. If we change it to 88.5, it should open up the speaker.
Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3.
So this is using 88.5, but radio 1 is not. So
menu.
We can check here. It's not using. So the effect of that is check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. Transmission does not go through the other side of the communication to the UHF side. So to be able to open up the speaker of the transceiver, and for the communication to pass through to the UHF radio, what we do is we have to set this to use the matching CTCSS code of our Wouxun transceiver, which is 88.5. So let's do it right now. That's
menu 13
on the Baofeng UV-5R. Menu again to enter the selection, and then from the options you choose 98.5 and confirm it with a menu.
Confirm.
Then exit and let's see. It's working, right? It's working. Let's
menu.
Put a Roger tone here. So 39.
Confirm.
And also you would notice that as I transmit, there is that CT icon here indicating that 155.180 is using a CTCSS tone as I transmit it on transmission. So this is T-CTCSS in the Baofeng UV-5R.
Check 123, check 123.
Alright. So to go back to the previous or the default RX-CTCSS tone of both sides, we should power cycle be KG-UV920P. So from a remote location, you can do the remote power off or power on procedure as shown here on our chart. This one, see, and we will do it right now. The KG-UV920P has been turned off remotely. To turn it on again, use the same procedure. 654321 up up 101 pound key. And it should turn on this time, retaining the default CTCSS setting. So the CT code or icon on side B is now gone, while there's still CT icon on side A because by default we have this set to 88.5. So how do we know that if it is really using 88.5 as the default?
Menu.
You can see here that the CTC, come on, so it's 88.5. Come on, there you go, confirm, let's try to transmit.
Check 123, check 123.
So it's still working. Now, what if we would like to change from 88.5 to say another CTCSS code? How about a 71.7? Okay, so we do procedure B once again here. So that would be 1, 2, 3 pound menu down. Okay, and then you do 050717. But there is no 0, there is no 71.7. So we try another value of maybe 100 to terminate it. Just press PTT and then 99. Then that should terminate all remote control software operation. And then you do procedure B once again. So 1, 2, 3 pound menu down. Release the PTT or HT controller, there's that beep. You do 0, 5, and since it's a 4-digit number, it's 100 and a 0. There's that CT icon indicating that it is now using a 100 CTCSS tone. Now to verify that the KG-UV920P is now using a 100.0 kHz of RX-CTCSS tone. You can see here that for our radio 1, the transmit CTCSS tone is 88.5. So what happens is that even if I transmit from here, it will be picked up by the, of course, side B RX, but the transmission will not be relayed to the UHF side of the communication. It does not open up the speaker because this does not have a matching code as the transceiver. So what we do now is we set this to
menu
100
CTCSS.
I have difficulty focusing it. So that's 100.
Confirm
it, and let's check. Works.
Check 1, 2, 3. Check 1, 2, 3.
Now for the other radio, let's see if this would work. Not working, because this is still using what, 88.5 of CTCSS tone, the transmit CTCS tone. But if we change this to 100, see what happens.
Confirm.
Works.
Check 1, 2, 3. Check 1, 2, 3.
So there you have it. That's basically how you do a remote changing of the KG-UV920P's RX-CTS tone, or the so-called reception continuous tone coded squelch. So I hope that helps. Maraming salamat. Thanks a lot for watching. Kind regards from the Philippines.